Judy was boring.
Hello.
Then Judy discovered Chumbacasino.com.
It's my little escape.
Now Judy's the life of the party.
Oh, baby, mama's bringing home the bacon.
Whoa, take it easy, Judy. The Chumba life is for everybody. So go to Chumbacasino.com and play over 100 casino-style games. Join today and play for free for your chance to redeem some serious prizes. Chumbacasino.com. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus terms and conditions apply. See website for details.
Hey, everyone. My name is Cassie. And on Once Upon a Time in Springfield today, my dad and I will be talking about...
Season 4, Episode 12, Marge versus the Monorail.
Okay, Dad, start the intro.
She's Cassie.
My dad's like Homer, because he always goes out and buys us donuts.
He's Chris.
Cassie used to be a lot like Maggie when she was a baby. She never gave up her pacifier.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to a wonderful evening of theater and picking up after yourself.
This is Once Upon a Time in Springfield, a Simpsons review show from the point of view of a dad and his daughter.
From now on, I'm just gonna sit back and enjoy the ride.
Here they are, Cassie and Chris.
In this episode, a con man sells the people of Springfield a monorail, but Marge warns them it's a mistake.
What the hell was that?
All right, Cassie, what was the chalkboard gag?
The chalkboard gag was, I will not eat things for money.
Which I'm sure we've all done.
Yeah.
What do you want to rate that one?
I will rate that one a 9.
Yeah, I like that. That's pretty good. All right, Cassie, what was the couch gag?
Everybody from the town joined in and... all went in front of the couch after the Simpsons sat down.
They all like crisscross applesauce and then a row on their knees so everybody could see each other. It's kind of funny. What do you want to rate that one?
I'll rate that one an 8.5.
Sounds good to me.
You're all nuts.
All right, it opens up to Homer sleeping at work, and it starts with the Flintstones theme.
Flintstones, meet the Flintstones.
But he sings it, Simpsons, meet the Simpsons.
Simpson, Homer Simpson, he's the greatest guy in history. From the town of Springfield, he's about to hit a chestnut tree.
It looked like his manager rang the bell and he slid outside and jumped through the window of his car, crashed it, and then
it
drove.
It was perfect.
It was kind of fun. And then it bounces over to Carl and Lenny, and they're sealing toxic waste barrels.
Yeah, because that's normal.
It is in a nuclear power plant, I bet.
True.
And then, Burns and Smithers are trying to hide them, so they go to the park, put it in a tree. Doesn't work very well.
No.
EPA comes and does what?
Takes them away to court.
Yeah, what happens in court?
In court, he's like, okay, that'll be $3 million or something like that. Like, he's like, Smithers, my wallet's in my front wipe. Right pocket.
Yeah, right. And he pulls out $3 million like it's in stacks, like it's in a stack of like 100 bills or something right in front of the judge. And he bought the statue right on the judge's desk too.
Yep.
Sold. But anyway, they're all sitting there and they're like, $3 million. What can the city do for $3 million? Everybody's imagining what they can get. Lisa's like, would she imagine?
She imagined that there'd be...
Oculuses.
Oculus.
Yeah, there'd be virtual reality helmets.
Yep, that'd be really cool though.
They nailed that one too. And then Bart's like, we need to have big, giant, robotic ants that kill everyone.
Yeah.
And then what did Homer want?
Homer wanted, like, this donut thing.
He's pretty simple. All right, so but they're now having the town meeting to decide what the money's for. What does Marge want it for?
Marge wants it for to fix the main street.
The road's
road
pretty crappy.
Because there's, like, literally potholes everywhere. It's cracking in, like, half. And there's one pothole that's bigger than all of the others. And this, who's driving in front of it?
I don't know who's driving it, but I know what kind of truck it was.
What type?
Popcorn.
Oh yeah. It was a popcorn truck. And it fell inside of it, and popcorn just, like, exploded everywhere.
Filled the whole hole up.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be fun to be the next car that went and crashed. Yeah, Apu wants more police. Reverend Lovejoy's wife wants to put the tire fire out. And then Lyle Langley comes in and says, you want a bona fide, genuine little monorail?
Yeah.
And then they sing.
Yeah.
What's it called?
Monorail.
Once again.
Monorail.
All right, let's jump to the middle. Everybody's excited about this monorail coming in except for Marge.
Because Marge is scared that it's too fast. It could break down. It might never stop.
Mm-hmm. And she's questioning.
She questions her.
Yeah, and then Lyle goes to the school and is talking about the monorail, and Lisa questions him.
You know, he didn't really have an answer. He just said that so that way he could feel not outsmarted by Lisa.
Yeah, he didn't really answer the question at all.
No, he didn't.
Nope, what a jerk of face.
I know.
Then they showed Truckosaurus on TV, which was cool. Because that was in an earlier episode, I believe, and it's on the game, too.
Yeah, it was really cool to me. the part where he went, I don't know whether to kiss you or eat you.
To the car.
To the car.
Right? And then there's a commercial for monorail conductors.
Monorail.
And what happens?
Really and Homer's like, wait, that's me.
Yeah, so Homer goes to the Lyle Langley School of Monorail Instructors.
Yep.
And has to take the MCAT. The Monorail Conductor Aptitude Test. I read the book.
Oh.
I read the cover of the book that they were using. But Homer does end up getting to drive the monorail, but Marge still's not convinced. Where'd she go?
She went to Stockton.
One of those other towns.
Oh.
Ogdenville, Marysmith.
Yeah. I've sold monorails to Brockway, Ogdenville, and North Haverbrook, and by gum, it put them on the map.
Whatever it was, and tried to find out what happened to their monorail.
Yes, because he went there before, and he said it worked out. But they get there, and she goes to this monorail cafe. I said that with quotation marks. And she went in, and it was like, there was no monorail. There was never a monorail.
The monorail cafe worker.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's like all freaked out.
And then she
like PTSD.
I know.
Yeah, Marge gets there and then she runs into this guy named Sebastian Cobb, I believe is his name. He's a scientist. He's in the game. Yeah, he has a fun story. He is a weird. He's glasses, white hair. He's kind of fun. And he goes, only you have a great monorail conductor.
Well, she didn't. No, she did.
Then it cuts over to Homer. What's he doing?
He accidentally locked his keys in the monorail, so we don't know.
He's got a clothes hanger trying to get it out like people would try to get keys out of a car. So silly. All right, we jump to the end. And then it's going to be the maiden voyage of the Springfield monorail. And all the celebrities have come out. What are you wearing?
It's a great question.
I know. Lurleen comes back out of the Betty Ford Clinic, which means she was at rehab. Krusty was there. Yeah. The one dude from Star Trek. What's his name?
Spock.
Yeah, he has ears like yours. The pointy.
Oh.
And he does this, live long and prosper. But even Quimby goes, yeah, may the force be with you to him. And he goes, do you even know who I am? That was really funny.
It was really funny. I like that part.
All right, so then Homer takes them on a ride. And what happens?
And they are on the ride. And if you guys didn't know, it worked by solar power. So
Homer took them on a ride.
And it didn't stop.
Yeah, it broke and went faster and faster.
And faster and
while
faster.
That's happening, Wiggum, Chief Wiggum, and Mayor Quimby are fighting over who's in charge. And then a solar eclipse. And then no solar eclipse. They do show Lyle Langley. Where's he at? He's in a plane to, like, the Bahamas or something.
Oh, yeah. He's like, I recognize that name.
Yeah.
Everybody gets in the plane with torches and they're all yelling.
Yeah, and then Homer gets a call from Marge, and Marge is like, homie, I have someone here that can help you.
Oh, he says, oh, it's Batman?
Yeah, he does. He says it a couple times.
Yeah.
No, it's a scientist. Batman's a scientist? No, it's not Batman. I love that part. So then basically the scientist says, hey, you got to get an anchor and slow down the monorail that way.
Yeah, so he goes into the aisle and is like, you. It's a cowboy.
Steals his rope.
And steals his rope, yep.
Then yanks the M off the side of the monorail.
Yeah, which was pretty smart.
Yeah. Then it goes through town and tears everything up. It disenjoins some Siamese twins. And then it lands in the lard land giant donut.
And this is why donuts exist.
I know, yeah. That's pretty true.
They save
our
lives.
And then at the very end, it's kind of funny because Marge goes, and this is, it was like she was telling a story. And then she goes,
and that was the only folly the people of Springfield ever embarked upon. Except for the popsicle stick skyscraper. And the 50-foot magnifying glass. And that escalator to nowhere.
All right, Cassie, what's your favorite part of the show?
My favorite part of the show was, okay, so before Homer went to go grab the rope,
mm-hmm.
He looks back at Bart because Bart is in like
in the he's in the cab with him. He's in the monorail.
Yeah, he's in like the monorail, but like in the spot where he can drive.
Driver, yeah.
He turns around and he's like, and he turns into a anchor. He's like, Homer, think harder.
Homer imagines Bart as the anchor, like an idiot. Yeah, I liked it when they were talking about what to spend the money on, and Bart and Homer didn't even imagine anything. He goes, what, like a giant billboard that says no fat chicks? Now, this was made a long time ago. Don't judge me. I'm just repeating what he said, but that's hilarious. That would never fly now.
Me fail English? That's impossible.
All right, Cassie, who's your favorite character?
My favorite character probably was Lisa.
Why?
Because Lisa just like was funny, you know?
Yeah.
She was a smarty.
She had Marge's concern, but with a, like a 10-year-old's thought.
Yeah.
All right. My favorite
like
character
me.
Was, yeah, exactly.
But I'm 11.
11. My favorite character is Homer because he just has a whole bunch of one-liners. Like I said before, he says, donuts, is there anything they can't do? There's a whole bunch of them in there. It's really good.
Yep.
I've got something I'd like to say.
All right, Cassie, we're going to rate this one.
We're going to rate this one 9.5 monorails.
Monorails? I don't know what a monorail is, but I know what a monorail is.
What's a monorail?
Monorail is just how they taught in that school. Mono means one, rail means on. You graduated.
I feel that way, too.
That's the end of the show, everyone. I hope you like the show as much as Maggie likes her pacifier or Homer likes his beer. Make sure you rate, review, and subscribe. Go to thisisfunner.com to check out some really cool shows. And please, share it with a friend.
Everything really wrapped up nicely.
Thank you all for listening to Once Upon a Time in Springfield. Please go to thisisfunner.com for more podcasts and online content. And don't forget to rate, review, and share the show with a friend.
Ugly Duckly done.
This is fun.
Okay, round two. Name something that's not boring.
A laundry? Ooh, a book club. Computer solitaire, huh?
Ah, oh, sorry. We were looking for Chumba Casino. That's right. Chumbacasino.com has over 100 casino-style games. Join today and play for free for your chance to redeem some serious prizes. Chumbacasino.com. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus. Terms and conditions apply. See website for details.